Okay, good evening for the Bible school, and this is the class Biblical Greek and Hebrew, and today we will be studying one very important word in the Bible and a teaching related to it. And today we will be speaking from Matthew chapter 12 about the blasphemy against the Holy Spirit. So the story goes like this. Matthew chapter 12 verse 22. Then was brought unto him, unto Jesus, one possessed with the devil. So here you have a man who has a demoniac, devilish possession. He was a blind, dumb, and he healed him insomuch that blind and dumb both spoke and saw. And all the people were amazed and said, "Is not this the son of David?" What does it mean? This is the messianic recognition. They say, "Is not this the son of David? Is not this the long expected and awaited Messiah?" Now, if you study rabbinic history and the custom of those days, the Jewish rabbis, they were able to cast out demons as well. And there was certain methodology. This methodology is exposed by Dr. Fruchtenbaum. And he is teaching, and he says that if you wanted to cast a demon out of a person, and we can see this in Mark chapter 5, when Jesus casted out the legion out of a demon-possessed man, he first asked him and he says, "What is your name?" He says, "My name is Legion," and then he says, "Come out of him." So this was the procedure in the three steps. First, you have to start the communication with the demons. You ask them and you find out their name. And by knowing the name, the demons are using the vocal cords of the demon-possessed person, so the person speaks and expresses the name of the demon. And then the Jewish rabbis were able to cast out the demon. In this case, the spirit is dumb and he cannot speak. So there is a difficulty, and in Jewish rabbinic traditions, it will be Messiah which will cast out a blind and dumb demon. Because Jesus did it, that's why everybody, all the people around, started to say, "Is not this the son of David? Is not this the Messiah?" He proved and he showed us the second messianic miracle that the Jews were teaching that he will do, and that's how we will recognize him, because nobody else is able to do it except the Messiah himself. And verse 24, "But when the Pharisees heard it, they said, 'This fellow does not cast out devils, but by Beelzebub, the prince of the devils.'" So they saw the miracle, they saw the messianic miracle, and they were not willing to recognize it or ascribe it to Jesus. So they said, "Yes, we cannot deny the miracle itself, but let's say he doesn't do it from the Holy Spirit, he does it by the devil himself, the prince of demons." And then he teaches them Jesus, and he says in verse 31, he basically says, "I am not doing it this by the power of demon. The kingdom would be divided. How can the devil cast out the devil?" And verse 31, he says, "Wherefore I say unto you, all manner of sin and blasphemy shall be forgiven unto men." Blasphemy will be forgiven unto men. All manner of sin and all manner of blasphemy. And you can see blasphemy even in the New Testament epistles. You can see it in the Old Testament writings. It will be forgiven. But there is one special but: the blasphemy against the Holy Spirit shall not be forgiven unto men. Verse 32, "Whosoever speaks a word against the Son of God, Son of Man, it shall be forgiven him. But whosoever speaks against the Holy Spirit, it shall not be forgiven him, neither in this world, neither in the world to come. Now, the key understanding of this blasphemy against the Spirit is the whole passage, as we said, and the Jewish historical background. Now, if you would read from the Mark chapter 3, verse 30, there is another very important explanation of the same situation. And Mark 3:30, he's adding this, and he says, again, he spoke against the blasphemy, and he says, verse 30, because they said, or let's read from the verse 29, but he that shall blaspheme against the Holy Spirit shall has never forgiveness, but is in condemnation of eternal damnation, because they said, he has an unclean spirit. That's the connection. Because they said he has unclean spirit. So to get a clean picture, imagine there is a Jesus who is coming on the scene. He is healing the demon-possessed man who is dumb. He cannot speak. Nobody is able to cast out such a demon except Messiah by rabbinic teachings. And Jesus performs this miracle. So he is able to do it. And common people recognize it. Matthew 12:23, they said, is not this the son of David? Is not this the long-awaited Messiah? And verse 24, the Pharisees say, no, this is done by the power of the devil himself. The blasphemy in this case is that Jesus revealed his messianship. He proved to them that he is the Messiah. And actually, they are blaspheming against the testimony of the Holy Spirit. In one sense, what more can I do for you? Here it is. Here is your demand for miracle. And they don't want to accept it, so they start to call it differently, and they say it's been done by the power of the Beelzebub, or the prince of all the demons, which is the devil himself. Now, the word blasphemy has this explanation in itself. When you look at the word blasphemy, we are still in Matthew 12:31, speaking about the blasphemy against the Holy Spirit. This word for blasphemy in the Greek is blasphemia, and it's compounded of another words. One is blapto, the other one is femia. We could say feme. This word for feman, we know this, we use it in English, it's a fame. You know, fame, rumor or saying, okay? So there is something, some rumor about somebody, some saying. And as you see, the Pharisees were blapto, stopping the fame about Jesus. They were stopping or forbidding that this fame would be presented as it is. They were stopping this explanation. This fame comes from, again, fame. Now you don't have eta at the end, you have an I. And this word now means appearance. And root of this word is a false. You know, false, and it's to shine, to manifest luminescence, and it's a light. So if you connect the dots, you have a light, you have an appearance, you have a theme or a rumor or saying, and then you have a blasphemia, someone who is stopping. Someone who is stopping the true rumor about Jesus, the true appearance or revelation about Jesus, which comes from the light. You know, light brings information. This light gives us some appearance about Jesus. He appeared, he revealed himself. There is his fame or saying, there is a certain saying about Jesus. And based on this miracle, the saying is, he is the son of David, he is Messiah. But the Pharisees, they were blapto, they were stopping this fame about Jesus. So it's very interesting to see all this and study all these words, because now you are getting amazing understanding of the true meaning. And I just lost it here, so let's see. Okay, doesn't matter. So this is the teaching. Blasphemy against the Holy Spirit, as we understand, is connected to this special event. Can you do the blaspheming against the Holy Spirit nowadays? You know, technically, no. In a hyperbolical sense, when we kind of apply it, maybe, and I will explain it. Technically, you cannot do it. Because this was for the certain time, for certain season, for this event, when Jesus met this man who was possessed with the devil, he was dumb, and he proved his Messiah. Everybody starts to cry, he is the son of David, that's the fame about him, that's the appearance, that's how he revealed himself appeared. But the Pharisees do blaspheme, they are stopping this fame, they are stopping this saying about Jesus, and they say, no, he is not Messiah, he is from the devil. So they are stopping the true revelation of messianship of Jesus Christ. Can you do this nowadays? No, Jesus is not here present, Jesus is not performing his second messianic miracle that he would prove to the Jews mainly and then to the world that he is the Messiah. He's not doing this anymore. He has proved this in the scriptures, in the past history already. So he's not in this business of proving his messiahship. So we cannot stop this. In a spiritual sense, if you are not receiving the revelation from God, if you are not receiving the revelation about Jesus being the Messiah, you are rejecting it, similar way like the Pharisees. And if you do not change your attitude, you will not be saved. So if we really like force it in this way, person could blaspheme against the Holy Spirit by not receiving the true revelation of who Jesus is, by rejecting it constantly. And basically this thing will not be forgiven, you know. That means you reject salvation and you go to hell. If you change your mind and you recognize he's from God, he's the Messiah, he is the son of David, you will receive salvation, you will be saved. But pertaining to the Pharisees, their hardness and an attack and evil which corrupted them, basically stopped them from recognizing the voice of the Holy Spirit. Jesus in the person is performing this miracle that they themselves believe that the Messiah will do it. He is fulfilling all the Testament prophecies about Messiah, and he is proving them his Messiahship, and they see it and they want to reject it. Therefore they say, that's from the devil. And Jesus turns at them and he says, this will not be forgiven, because you reject it, as he says in Mark 3:30. Let me see it at the end. It's the same passage, just described with a little bit different words, and we get a broader picture, because they said he has unclean spirit. That's it. Because they said he does this by unclean spirit, he does it by the devil. They rejected the proof that he is Messiah. So it's amazing. Let's remember this word, and we will do another Bible studies. Maybe next time we will be teaching about the correct translation of John 3:16. and John 1:1 and 1:2, and because there are like many mistakes in Bible translations, and we will see how to read the correct translation of the scripture from Greek into English, or we can say even into Serbian language. We will have a look on it. So thank you. God bless you. Amen.